In this video, I'm going to explain how to write simple conditional statements using Python. A conditional statement is simply a statement that you write where you check against a condition to execute a certain piece of code. So you basically say, if this value equals this, then execute this, otherwise execute this. So these are called if statements, and I'm going to show you how to write a simple if statement using Python. Let's go ahead and open up our project using the Atom editor. So we'll open up the project that we had in the previous lesson where we created our variables and our hello world file. And we're going to create a new file called conditions.py. And this in here, we're going to learn how to make a simple if statement. Before we write an if statement, I'm going to explain the two most basic conditions that you might use in your Python code. I'm going to use comments to write how to explain how to use the different conditions. So a comment is just a line preceded by a hash symbol. And all this does is tells Python, do not execute this line of code. It's just a bit of text for informational purposes. Okay, so the first condition is the equals. So you check if one value equals another value. Now, because we use the single equals operator to assign a variable, the way that you need to do an equals if you are comparing values is you do two equals. So if you say equal equal, then this is a comparison. You are checking one side of the equals equals the other. The next is the does not equal. So the not equals, the way that you write that is you do exclamation mark and equals. So this is if does equal and this is does not equal. Okay, so these are the two most simple operators that you would use in Python. There are more operators that you can use, but we'll cover them in later videos. Okay, now I'm going to show you how to form a simple if statement using Python. Python uses indentation to separate the different blocks of code. So indentation is just when you write, it's just how many spaces you put before the line of code you write. So the way you do an if statement is you type if and then the condition. So let's say we want to check if one equals equals one, not two. So if one equal equals one, then you do a colon and then you write the code that you want to execute if this is true. So let's just do a simple print and we'll just print one equals one. Save that and let's run our code. So open up your command prompt or your terminal window. And then if you remember from the previous lesson, the way that you run it is you type Python and then the name of the file you want to execute. Let's run that. Now, of course, one equals one. We already knew that. But then I'm just trying to demonstrate how you write an if statement. So this is the most simple if statement here. So that an if statement can have three components to it. The first is the first check that you want to do. Then you write any secondary checks that you want to do. So that's called else if. And then you write an else statement. So it's better if you compare, if we demonstrate by comparing a variable. So you don't actually need to specify the numbers because this wouldn't be much use. But where it becomes useful is when you check the condition of a variable that may be set elsewhere in the code. So let's define a variable called apples. And let's set it to 7. And let's change our if statement to compare if apples equals 7. So we'll remove this text here and we'll just write if apples equals 7, then print apples is 7. Save that, run it, and you can see it outputs apples is 7. So next, let's write an else statement. So let's say if apples equals 7, do this, otherwise execute this. Let's type else, print apples does not equal 7. All right, so of course apples does equal 7. So let's just change this to 8. So if we set apples to 8 and then we print this, it will say apples does not equals 7. Okay, so now we can try inverting this using the not equals. So we say if apples does not equal 7, apples does not equal 7. And if this is true, so if it's not equal 7, then print apples does not equal 7. Otherwise, print apples does equal 7. Or equals 7, not equals. And save and run, and you can see apples does not equal 7. We change it to 7. It says apples does not equal 7. It says apple does equal 7. Yeah, I'm confusing myself here because it can get quite confusing when you work with negative operators like this. Okay, so let's change this back to double equals. So we'll check if apples equals 7. And let's add an else if. The else if is a secondary condition that we check with, or we check against underneath this before we reach the else statement. So let's type L if. The syntax for writing an else if in Python is you simply type L if. They shortened it and just merged them together. I think they did that just because it's cleaner than writing something like else if, or it's shorter. You just type L if, and then the secondary condition that we want to check. Let's want to check if apples equals 8. And then colon, and then the line of code underneath that we want to execute if this is true. Apples equal 8. Change this to just apples equals 7. And then our if statement now should, or our else statement should become apples does not equal 7 or 8. And you can add as many of these if statements as you want. So you can go and write elif apples equals 9, and you can go 10 and so on. We're just going to keep the two here just to demonstrate it working in its simplest form. And let's run this. So it says apples equals 7. If we change it to 8, it says apples equal 8. If we change it to 56, it says apples does not equal 7 or 8. Okay, so that's how you formulate a simple if statement in Python. I hope you found this useful. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.